I've also never seen as much blatant perjury. Just, I mean, as an officer of the court, you know that we're all held to a higher standard. And the ease at which officers of the court, prosecutors, would lie was breathtaking to me. Just,
yeah,
tells me they've been doing it for a very long time without consequence.
Well, and they didn't turn over a bunch of evidence to you. Then they turned some over in, after you start trial. And then I still question whether or not you really ever got everything.
Because I haven't.
You know, the feds have probably held back some stuff that you are likely entitled to, that they weren't willing to give up on this deal.
That is a true story.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you this, Jimmy, the things that were turned over to us in the middle of trial, if they had given that to us prior to trial,
it would have affected your
They couldn't have put their case on. Those experts that testified about what this conflict was really about, every single piece of late disclosed evidence undermined their theory of prosecution.
Well, then
every single piece.
And then you have prosecutors on the record making an argument that, well, I didn't believe this witness, so therefore I don't have to give this piece of evidence to you.
It was Kelly Siegler all over again. Like, if she thinks they're crazy and don't make any sense, then it's not. Then you're not entitled to it, defense attorney.
Terrible. Terrible. Did the jurors pick up on that?
Yes, they did.
They did, and we were lucky enough. Well, you know, we forgot to mention Vivek Jampala. He was another co-counsel. He was, you know, very active, making a record of all, you know, keeping track of all of these issues throughout the trial for us.
So we both had our own appellate section. So the state did, and then Vivek was ours. But they could not have tried this case the way they wanted to if they had given me that evidence.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw this. The first chair in McLennan County is this guy named Michael Jarrett. And I did see a shift in his behavior midway through trial. Like, at one point, I'm getting records middle of trial from DPS, and Michael's looking at them, and I can tell from his face he's never seen them before.
Wow.
So it's not just McLennan County. The bad guy in this entire prosecution is the Department of Public Safety. Well, would be DPS.
And you issued subpoenas on this stuff. And,
yeah.
They were quashed.
Yes.
And it was more than that, though, because at one point Michael was saying, well, Judge, we'd like that too, and he was corrected. He was corrected, and
elected DA comes in and says, oh, we've already received that. And no.
Really?
So there were filters of information. So DPS would generate it, and DPS is boots on the ground for any federal investigation in Texas.
Sure.
Have you seen the federal indictment for the Bandidos case out of San Antonio?
Long time ago. Okay. I haven't looked at it recently.
Is that the one Schaefer was on? No.
Schaefer was on it, and I think Dick DeGaren is now counsel for Jeff Pike. So it tracks all of these predicate acts from 2013.
Mm-hmm.
Gets all the way up to Waco, skips it, and then continues.
Ha!
Interesting.
Yeah.
Just hanging low.
It is interesting, isn't it?
Wow. So they just decide to omit that. Blinders on.